Welcome back to Mass Effect Andromeda. In the last episode, we kind of finished up for the time being on the planet Eos, and we're heading back to the Nexus. In the meantime, I found out this guy's quite the lady killer. He's been running around the ship just romancing any female he can find. But wait, there's more. I don't think he's found all the females. So let's go up and see if there's something else for this guy to do.
Strike team ready for deployment.
Okay, so it seems like PB said she was in a pod.
I'm in the galley when you're free.
We've already talked to these guys, but they keep coming up with the same thing. When I get close to where they're at, they seem to want to tell me where they're at if I need to talk to them. But I've already talked to them. So, let's see. We need to go this way. And, let's see. Now, PB said she was in... That's the bridge. PB said she was in one of the pods. Now, where were the pods? Bathroom. Okay, the pods were up on the bridge, I believe, maybe. Let's see. Yeah. There's a pod here, I think.
We haven't really spoken since orientation, have we?
Nope, not this one.
It's all been so hectic, but I'm sure things will quiet down soon. Can't...
You're sitting
here we
up
go.
In here, huh?
Yeah, I'm going through what we got out of that vault. If I can crack this data storage box, it'll help with a personal project back on the Nexus. This is a nice, out-of-the-way place where I can tinker, and I can sleep anywhere. It's not exactly homey, but I like that about it. Not really looking for a home. Oh, but I will help you find everyone a home. While I'm with you, at least.
Not sticking around?
Should I consider you a temporary addition?
Everything's temporary, Ryder. I get it. You want to know who's on your ship, so you're here to figure out what makes me tick, right?
Something like that? Sure.
Well, I was born in a log cabin on rural Haitiana to simple but loving parents, just trying to... I look forward, not back, Ryder. Why snooze through my life story? Get to know me out in the field while we're uncovering the mysteries of this galaxy. That's why I'm here. Got tired of yawning back home.
All right, so this girl, she's completely ready to run whenever she needs to. She must have some kind of commitment problems, and I'm not talking romance commitment necessarily. I think commitment problems, you know, per se, just being part of the team, that kind of thing. So you crave excitement, huh? You should try sleeping more. Boredom drove you here. Crave excitement.
Tackling complete strangers in the Milky Way wasn't doing it for you?
I think tackling you anywhere would be fun. Did I say that out loud? Life won't be boring with you around. I may never yawn again.
Yeah, but you look like a raccoon. So, boredom drove you here then.
You left everything and everyone you knew because you were bored?
No. I came with someone I knew. Then she got bored with me. Ryder, the Milky Way was so... been there, done that. Even if I hadn't done it, someone had. If there's one thing you should know about me, it's that I live for the unknown. For the never been done.
Yeah, I'm not buying it completely.
That's just the one thing you want me to know about you.
Let's start with that, then. Buy me a drink sometime. Who knows what will spill out of my mouth.
The drink,
tell
you mean?
Tell you what. I need remnant scrap. Remtech, I call it. For projects like the one I mentioned. Which you're gonna love, by the by. Promise to bring me what you scrounge, and I'll submit to all your questions.
Remtech, huh? You got it.
Okay, well, so she's gonna be a pistol, I think. Let's see if she got anything else to say.
You again. Want to hear more about my childhood log cabin?
Yeah. But, let's see. All right, tell me about the remnant, because that's what got us going here on this planet.
What drew you to the remnant?
Are you kidding? It's evidence of a sophisticated species no one knows anything about. It doesn't get more intriguing than that. There's so much to discover. I want to be the first to figure them out. And the tech, it's on a different scale. If we can appropriate it, who knows what advances we'll make.
In a way, she kind of reminds me of Leonie. Okay. Tell me about your current project. You mentioned something.
You really won't tell me what you're working on.
That's right. Next question.
All right, fine. Tempest crew?
So how do you like the team?
Interesting bunch. I get a good feeling from Vetra. Not your typical military-minded Turian. Liam seems a lively one. I expect he'll surprise me. Drek is, well, old. Wonder if he can still learn new tricks.
What about...
Gil smacks of complication. Might take some unraveling. Callow and Suvi seem busy. I hope they aren't all work, work, work. Who's left?
Well, there's...
Oh, right. Cora. What's her deal? Is she as prim and proper as she comes across?
All right. Hey, it's my turn to talk.
Oh, is it my turn to talk?
Sorry. Yeah, I should work on my motor.
You might find that people reveal themselves more freely if you give them a chance. Cora included.
Really good advice.
There's also Lexi, our doctor. She's an Asari.
Oh, I'll get around to her. All in all, seems like a decent bunch.
I don't think she likes the doctor. I don't think there's anything personal there. I just don't think she likes being poked and prodded and touched, if you will.
What was it like for you on the Nexus?
Well, I wasn't supposed to be woken up yet. A resourceful accomplice finagled my early thaw. So I kind of lived off the grid. Snuck around, bullshitted my way onto excursions off station. After I found my first remnant ruin, I started, borrowing shuttles.
Oh, that's what you
After
call that.
After that, I didn't spend much time on the Nexus. I even missed most of the revolt.
Huh. Flirting. Okay. I know this guy's a hound. I kind of explained what you're doing here. I don't know which way to go with any of these characters, so I'm just kind of going with it.
What does someone have to do to get you to flirt with them?
Not much at all. But I get a little extra jolt when I'm matched wink for wink. So just be yourself and the flirts will flow.
But you look like a raccoon. Oh, anyway, anyone special?
You mentioned you came to Andromeda with someone?
Nothing gets by you. Guess that's why you're the Pathfinder. Just a friend. The one who woke me up early. But now she's not even that. It's better to venture into the unknown without restraints or entanglements, don't you think?
Sounds lonely to me.
I don't know. Don't friends and loved ones make all the effort worthwhile?
I've always been self-motivated. Don't need much more than curiosity to drive me forward.
Well, all right, I think I've exhausted everything here.
You're off the hook, BB. Good luck with your project.
Thanks. Don't be a stranger.
All righty. Let's see. Now, back to the bridge. Oh, we're on the bridge. Let's talk to this feller. Gelo.
Glad you stopped by. You'll pardon me if I keep an eye on our vector?
That's probably smart.
Nothing like being on the bridge of your very own ship, is there?
Yeah, you said something about helping to design it.
You mentioned something about helping design the Tempest?
Test pilot, mostly. Plunging through the Nemean Abyss was almost a preparation for the Scourge. Of course, it took a whole team to build the Tempest. I was the only one to come to Helios, though.
Why did you?
What can I say? We poured our hearts into a ship that wouldn't realize her potential until Andromeda. I could have stood on the shore and waved goodbye, or took the leap to see how it all turned out.
Hmm. Big step for one ship.
I like the Tempest, but I'm not sure I'd travel between galaxies for her.
The Unknown Frontier had its charms, too. It's just strange not having the rest of the design team. I remember Serena debugging line 2281 over and over, chewing that green pencil. Tion and O'Connell arguing equations, tapping on the console. 3 drips of coffee on the corner.
You remember all that?
Hmm? Oh, yes. Solarians have photographic memories, and apparently mine's unusually sharp. Like my past is still happening. Though I suppose with the Salarian arc missing, you might not get many chances to compare.
I didn't realize they all had photographic memories. Do you know anything about the Ark?
Did you hear anything about the Ark back in the Nexus?
Not a peep. Isn't that strange? You'd think there'd be something.
Yeah, you would, wouldn't you?
Not that I dislike your company, but it's lonely without other Salarians.
Well, we'll find... Well, there's Tan. I don't even want to say that, but it's here.
Cheer up, Callow. We'll always have Director Tan.
That snide little bureaucrat? All the more reason to find the others. I should get back to it, but thank you. I was afraid the Tempest would be mothballed after we lost your father. We built her for this. She deserves to be in a Pathfinder's hands. Please, come by any time.
All right. Now, I've been talking twice to these people. Let me see if he's got anything else to say.
What can I do for you?
Yeah, he does. Tell me about Salarians.
You know, I haven't actually met many Salarians.
Careful. Depending who you ask, we're conniving spies, genius researchers, or meddling scientists. We have to pack a lot of living into 40-odd years. Everything gets accelerated. Lines blur. I just hope we don't repeat our old mistakes out here.
Wow, they only live 40 years? Any opinion on the others?
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Well, I can't talk about Suvi. She's sitting right there.
I'm not listening. You can say whatever you like.
Oh, no. I'm not falling for that again.
He's already done it. Oh, God. Any Tempest stories?
If you helped to build the Tempest, you must know plenty about her.
Just about everything. By memory, it was quite the effort to get her working. The Initiative needed absolutely up-to-date technology, which we all had to coordinate, and some of it was rather tricky to acquire.
Acquire?
Buy. Legally and above board, of course. Yes.
Of course.
Sadly, the other Pathfinder vessels were lost when the Scourge hit the Nexus. The Tempest is truly unique.
Yes, wondering about that.
I'll let you concentrate.
You know where I'll be.
Yep, sitting in that chair right there. All right, let's go talk to Suvi. Hey, Suvi. What's shaking?
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
Yep, it does have its beauty.
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon.
Darkly beautiful. I like that. Helios is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it. So alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
Okay, so she's kind of religious. So if you want to get on her good side, you kind of have to play along with that. Yeah. Oh, I've always thought the same.
There's something about coming face to face with something wondrous that makes you want to believe.
This guy has no shame.
It's wonderful to meet someone who understands. I've had to justify myself so often, as if having faith in the divine invalidated my work as a scientist. As if this sacred could be diminished by the search for truth.
This guy's a hound. He's just trying to get on your good side. Yeah. Yeah, you don't have to justify it.
I wasn't questioning your abilities. You never have to justify yourself to me.
Thank you. I appreciate you saying that, truly. Now I should probably update the rest of the team with my latest reports. We'll talk later.
I want to talk now. I like your accent.
I saw pictures of the vault. Astounding how big it is. And how much of it didn't you see? What if it's way bigger? What's all that space for?
Parties? Parties? It could go deep.
With what it has to do, it could go thousands of miles below the surface of the planet.
Or completely span it. An underground network. Just a thought, of course. I wouldn't even know where to start hypothesizing how it all works. The Remnant Builders, whoever, whatever they were, accomplished something far beyond us.
Yeah. Tell me a little bit more about your faith.
When did you start believing in a god?
My parents were both scientists. My home was ruled by rationality. So when I became a teenager, let's just say that while other kids found Batarian music, I found God.
So you rebelled.
But your work as a scientist
convinced me even more, especially when I got into molecular biology, physics. The patterns I kept seeing over and over again, they were like an artist's watermarks. God, to me, is an artist, an inventor, not someone checking to see if I brush my teeth.
Well, did you brush your teeth? Tell me about the science team on the Nexus.
I take it you work closely with the Nexus science team?
I try to keep in contact with them. We discuss anything and everything we discover out here. After all, many brains are better than one, and Dr. Aridana is worth two or three at least. I work best when I have other people to bounce ideas off of.
Okay. Tell me about the Andromeda scans.
I'm still fuzzy about how we managed to see Andromeda all the way from home.
It confused me too. I mean, the light lag would have made any data 2 million years out of date. So I asked Dr. Aridana, and she told me, well, it wasn't her tech that did it. It was the Geths.
You're kidding. Those killer robots we had in the Milky Way?
Those exact ones. The Initiative obtained data from an array in deep space. A Geth construct. According to Aridana, the Geth rebuilt a mass relay and turned the approach corridor into an FTL sensor.
A what now?
It operated like a telescope, just faster than light. It provided much more up-to-date info. We don't know why the Geth were interested in observing beyond the galaxy, though. Maybe we'll never know.
Maybe we'll find them here, and we don't, when we least expect it. Did my dad know that?
Did my dad know about this? Why didn't he tell me?
It's possible he didn't know. The Geth are isolationist and hostile. Using the info, even obtaining it in the first place, probably crossed a lot of boundaries.
Huh. What do you know about the terraforming?
What do you know about the Remnant's terraforming network?
From what I can tell, the vault is designed to adjust almost everything about a planet. Climate, pH of the soil, atmosphere composition. There's even evidence that it can propagate life. If we can figure out how to control the vaults, we could turn these worlds into perfect habitats.
Interesting. How about the Scourge?
What do you know about the Scourge?
We established that it's artificial. Someone put it there. Or they did something that caused its creation. We don't know why. That's still a mystery.
Interesting. Okay, thanks.
I should get back to things.
Sounds good.
Alrighty. I'm thinking the romance with her might take a little bit more work. Alright, heartfelt thanks. Oh, I've got a bunch of emails. To Ryder from Dr. Aridana. The families of my lost expedition asked me to convey their appreciation to you for finding their loved ones. It's always difficult when we lose people, but knowing what happened will help them begin the mourning process. I hope your next excursion has a happier ending. Yeah, that's too bad. Asking for assistance. It's the doctor again. Hello, Ryder. Forgive the intrusion. I have an issue that you and Sam should be able to readily solve. It may assist my investigations into the Scourge. We can discuss it in person at the Nexus Labs. My regards to you and Sam. All right. So that doctor wants to see me. Reminder. Thanks for talking. Things feel better. This is from Cora. Things feel better, though they don't feel fixed yet. Remember to take time for yourself, too. Work's important, but so is time to grieve. Grief and fear cannot rule you. Let them be your faithful servants, protective of their mistress. Loss serves a huntress like fuel serves fire. S. Theris, 12 Leaves, verse 132. Cora, P.S. Plants are coming along. Sam and I are learning about botany together. Interesting times. The Vault, from Cora. Can still smell that remnant vault on my armor. A lot of weird shit down there. Like my Huntress manuals would say, the razor's edge between known and unknown teaches you what can be cut away. Now I think back, it reminded me a little bit of some of the temples on Thessia. Some huge spaces and running water. Same sense of huge purpose that you can't really understand. Makes me wonder if we'll ever really know what their builders did there, Korra. Tempest Hacks from Kalo. I'm pleased to report the Tempest is operating at peak efficiency, so now that you're in command, I thought I'd share a few secret shipboard hacks that the designers and I sneaked into her code. Just send the code JCSB through your Omni tool to open the debug command. Huh? Let you see coffee dispenser in the galley an unlimited number of times. Oh, it's giving me cheats. Water temp overrides the normal hot water ration in the showers. Jump wash queue puts your clothing ahead of everyone else's in the laundry cycle. What? Enjoy and don't share them. Oh, he's talking about in-game hacks. I thought he was talking about the console. Proud to be here, Liam. Hey, Pathfinder, just hitting this point again. Our team, no place I'd rather be. Here's where we get to fix things. Soon as we have people on the ground, I'll have eyes on how to get them what they need. This sort of just make it happen is why I joined Husty One, and exactly why I came here. We'll do it, Costa. All right. You're the boss, Vetra, Pathfinder. I thought I ought to clarify. No, I said something about back channels, doing what I have to do. Being on the Nexus during the bad times, a lot of us got used to a lot of ugly things because survival just isn't that pretty. But in the end, I'm here to help you. So if there's anything you don't like, I won't do it. Simple as that. Spirituality. Dear writer, I'm so glad for our first chat earlier. I've had to defend what I believe so often, and I have to admit, I'm a little tired of it. Whenever I meet someone who feels the same or just understands, I really appreciate it. So, thank you, Suvi. About your dad, from Drac. Vetra told me what happened to your dad. I've lost a lot of people over the years. Figured you could use some cheering up, or at least a distraction. This usually helps me. 37 images of various rifle shotguns. 2 are duplicate images. Many are low res or watermarked. Okay, fine. In case you're interested, writer from Lexi. Attached is my Krogan thesis that I mentioned to you. I know only 500 pages, but I wasn't allowed to go over. If you get through it, I wrote a longer dissertation for the Citadel Journal of Medicine, around 1,400 pages. That's much more than insightful, includes mating diagrams. Oh my God, it's pornography. Krogan pornography. And something to read while, if you can't sleep, I guess. Yoga poses. Given the amount of high-impact cardio in your exercise routine, I recommend spending 5 to 10 minutes a day stretching to open your hips and relieve tightness in the lower back. The poses I've listed below should be do nicely. Not too sound elitist, but while it's true humans invented yoga, the Asari perfected it. All right, that's enough of that. We don't yoga around here. Interviews. Oh, that's that girl that wants me to make some kind of a video. All right. Let's see. What do we need to do now? I guess, I don't know. I guess maybe we're ready to go. All right. Let's use this.
I'm picking up something.
Like what? Alright, we're going to do this later, but right now I want to go back to the Nexus. So, let's hit this. And here's what I want to do. As soon as we get in the system.
Familiar territory.
The Nexus has been here for months. Still not enough time to survey all.
Okay, So
anomaly detected.
Right. She says there's anomaly detected. Every system we go to has got different things around here. And you probably should take the time to visit each one. If for no other reason, there's a lot of resources out there. So I'm going to quickly do this before we go into the Nexus. So we're going to scan and see what she's talking about when she says there's something out there.
Probe away. Anomaly found.
Wow, that's kind of cool. I don't know what that is, but it's kind of cool. Element Zero deposit, an unusually rich deposit of Element Zero. This appears to be a primary source broken up by space-time distortions in the Scourge. So let's scan that. We got all that information, and let's pick it up. We got plus 47 Element Zero. Now, here's something that's kind of cool. If you hit the exit key here, T, we can come back to the ship, and now we're parked out in space. If you're really interested in looking around, this is kind of cool. All right, let's go back into the system view here, and I'm going to start at the center and work our way out. Let's go to Phizine. Now that's a blue planet.
I'm picking up something.
Alright, Suvi's picking up something. Let's see what it is. Volcanoes? I don't know what that is. Looks pretty damn hot to me though.
Probes launched. Anomaly found.
Okay, this volcano has recently erupted. Phizin's usually strong gravity, 3.2 Gs. Means the lava flow is localized and may be valuable for study. Cool. Got some experience out of it. Now, Phizine, the analysis is an extremely hot and volcanically active world. A thick carbon dioxide and ethane atmosphere covers an iron-rich surface with deposits of calcium. Cool. All right, let's just move our way out of the system. We're at the first ring. Let's go second ring.
On sensors,
she says. On sensors. Whoa, what's that? So, H-599, with its distinctive ring, H-599 was used as a rendezvous point during the Nexus' early attempts at exploration. Pilots still use the term a 99 run for a short journey with numerous hazards.
Probe away. Detecting what's left of a ship.
Oh my, what is this? A caryatid is heavily damaged and adrift, but salvageable. Whoa, what the heck did this hit? Alright, oh, look at all the stuff we got. It's a Quarian nav processor. Whoa. Huh. I wonder what happened to it. We don't know, I guess. All right. Now, the next ring out appears to be the Nexus. So let's go. No, wait a minute. Does it? Maybe not. What's this? 1, 2, 3. All right, let's check this one out. This looks a little bit like EOS. Right now, Suvi didn't give us any information here, so I think this is just, there's nothing seems to be here. Gongzhen is small but scorching world, partially due to a crushing nitrogen carbon dioxide atmosphere. Evidence suggests its icy ring was once a small comet. So, no real information there. All right, let's run out to... okay, Nexus is the next ring. Let's go to the outer ring. Mahan. Are we looking at the moon or the planet? Oh, I guess we're looking at the planet. Mahan is largely composed of hydrogen and methane. Its relative proximity to the Nexus makes it a useful core discharge site. Plans for a helium-3 skimming station are in progress. Okay. Now, if you look, our progression is 83%, so... we're missing something, and it must have to do with this right here. So did we not scan this planet when we... I guess probably we haven't. We took right off, didn't we? All right, so there's information here. Headquarters of Andromeda Initiative Nexus is massive. Okay, I guess we had to come back to get the 100% scan on this system. Let's go in. This guy's not as cocky as Joker, is he? We'll probably see some areas we haven't seen before coming back.
Pathfinder, is it true? We're settling EOS.
We thought that before.
But EOS is different now, right? Pathfinder.
All right, settle down. Give him space. Lieutenant Syax, Kendros' aide. They all wanted to see you. Real hope again. It's been a while.
Yeah, just doing my job.
They've got a Pathfinder again. This is what we do.
And you've done it splendidly.
Professor Herrick, right?
What you achieved with that remnant vault is unprecedented, Pathfinder. Impossible.
With more military personnel out of stasis, those Ket won't get near your vault, or our people.
Yeah, the outpost has a good leader, seems like.
August Bradley will oversee that. He's the new mayor.
Bradley? I know him. Seems like a good man.
Well, what are you waiting for? There's a new world out there.
Thank you, Ryder.
Yeah, cool. I saw all those people there. I thought they were going to tackle me. I said, what'd I do now? Search for memory triggers that will unlock Sam's array. Okay, let's see what we've got to do. That now this is all new, this dock area. We didn't see this before. Is that what's her name? Vetra.
Don't.
Can I talk to her?
Don't shove the crate off the... You shove the crate off the ramp. Where do they find these people?
Keeping tabs on things back here?
Yeah, I try to watch what's going on while we're away, but it's nice to check in person.
Come on, you need to relax a little.
Shore leave is for relaxation. Take some time off. Get a massage. Contourians even get massages?
Sort of. We get vibrations through the carapace with a hammer. Not for me.
Are you kidding?
I'm fine, just people watching.
All right. She's kidding, right?
Such a mess.
Probably not. All right, so let's see what we have to do on the Nexus here. Rider family secrets. Search for memory triggers that will unlock Sam's array. Okay, so we've already kind of done that. We found one, but missing arcs. Priority ops. These missions are critical to the initiative. First strike. Inspect available strike team mission. I haven't done that yet. I'm not quite sure what that's all about. A better beginning. Speak with Tan at the Nexus and give EOS radiation a time to clear. So we need to speak to Tan. And then this AVP cryo deployment. What is that? Speak with Addison. All right, so we've got to speak to those people. Let's get that out of the way. I'm almost sure that if we walk around here, we're going to get more quests. And I'm not entirely sure if I want to do that. And I'm afraid if I don't, though, and I keep carrying on with the main quest line, that these will go away and I won't ever have the chance to do them. So let's go to Operations Center first.
Construction and repairs continue on various...
I've said this before, but I'm so glad that this tram is faster than the elevators in the previous games. All right, we're back. So let's go up and talk to the scientists first. I know that one scientist wanted to talk to me. Of course, I don't know if they're still up here. There's different people up here. Wow, there's different people up here than there were. Where'd the scientists go? Oh, did they finally give them a lab? I'll bet they did. I bet they finally gave them a lab since... Who's this? Oh, this is Vetra's sister.
Pathfinder. I'm Cid, Vetra's sister. Vetra's told me all about you. Well, not all about you, but the important bits. What? I should probably get back to work. It was real nice meeting you, though.
The important bits? What is it that you do?
What work do you do here?
Oh, I just monitor comms from colonists. Progress updates, hazards encountered. Note it down, pass on a report to Sean at the end of the day.
Important job.
I know. It's nice to hand in a report and have someone say I helped.
Well, yeah. I'll let you get back to work.
And you get to know all the stuff that's happening right up to right at the time it happens. That's cool. Oh, we had the murder thing, didn't we? Hang on. Helios assignments. Nexus. First murder. Okay, we need to confront Nilken because if you remember, we found out that he didn't actually kill the guy. His shot missed, but he intended to kill the guy. It's just... his good luck, if you will, that he missed.
Hey, there's puke on the floor. I'm gonna get sick.
What?
You're sick. Locking a man up with germs. If I die, I'm gonna sue your ass.
Oh, he's a drunk.
Blowing that hot air, pal. Go dry out fast.
All right, Rensis.
I hear you went down to EOS. Did you find anything to help my case?
You lied to me.
You're a liar. The Chief's Omnitool recorded you over the body admitting to killing him.
What? Wait, that's not... What are you trying to pull?
Sam, playback.
Sorry, old friend. Had to do it. I'm not dying on this rock. Well, shit. Guess my fate is sealed.
Except that your shot missed. A Ket blast to the back killed Reynolds.
Are you serious? I'm innocent? What a stroke of luck. The conviction will have to be overturned. The sentence thrown out.
Well, that's for Tan to say.
Director Tan will determine what's to be done. You did try to cover it all up.
Look, I'm sorry I lied, but if my shot missed, I'm innocent, plain and simple.
We'll see about that.
You're just lucky. That's what you are. All right, so I guess we got to go talk to Tan now for two reasons. One about the colony, and one about this, so-called murderer. I guess he's not.
Pathfinder, do you have just a minute?
Nah, I'm busy. Whoa, this place has changed.
Hello, Director Tan is expecting you.
Last time I was here, this was a storage closet.
Pathfinder Hall just needed a Pathfinder to open.
We're still getting the commons area ready. Hydroponics is only at partial capacity.
Not good enough.
We don't have enough people. My workers need a break, Tan.
I sympathize, but not until our survival is no longer at risk. Now please excuse me while I meet with our Pathfinder. Hey, Ryder. Addison told me about the outpost. You're the hero of the hour.
Yeah? You're going to try to figure out how you can ride my coattails? No, I'm going to take the high road again. I'm not going to say what I'd like to say. Still a big job ahead.
Let's hold off on the celebration. We haven't found home yet.
Oh, there's no need for modesty. Success affords leverage over those who doubted you.
And you're my best friend?
A patron. One who shares your vision of a prosperous future.
You don't know me.
Due respect, Director Tan, but you don't know me.
Oh, I think I do. Your ingenuity speaks for itself, Ryder. Deciphering the vault, alien terraforming. It's not how we imagined all this, but a good Pathfinder improvises. And a great one hangs it on the wall.
What?
Yours are the first trophies to grace Pathfinder Hall. You're a symbol now, Ryder. A reason for people to believe.
Yeah, it was a team effort. I didn't do it by myself.
It wouldn't have been possible without my crew. They're a talented bunch.
But you're their beacon.
Careful. He'll end up adopting you, Ryder.
Ah, my staff.
Colleagues. You wouldn't be looking to cut us out, would you, Tan?
I remind you, I am the director of the initiative.
Acting director.
Yeah, their opinions matter.
This isn't the time for arguing over who gets to be king. Too much is at stake. We should be cooperating.
That's what I've been saying since we arrived.
Then I look forward to winning our Pathfinder support.
Though I worry about your decision on Eos, Ryder. A military outpost won't help feed the Nexus, not the way scientists might have.
But it will protect us from a growing list of threats.
And we could argue about it all day long, as we always do. The decision was made. Now we move on. What is your plan for moving on, Ryder?
We have a lead on the terraforming network. I need to take the Tempest deeper into the sector to investigate. If the other Golden Worlds are where they should be, this could get us closer to them.
Careful. The Ket are scouring the cluster for remnant technology. You'll end up in a fight, for sure. You might also run into exiles. They didn't leave the Nexus on good terms.
And we still need more outposts. They're important to expanding the station.
Though with Ark still missing, this could be a chance for Ryder to search for them. Yes, I think that's best. You have my permission.
I don't need your permission.
I wasn't really asking for it.
Of course. I support that kind of enthusiasm.
Oh, jeez.
Right.
This guy's a real politician, isn't he?
Ryder, this is Harry, back on the Ark.
Go ahead.
We may have found a way to talk to your sister, sort of. Drop by when you can, Hyperion Medbay.
We'll do. Yeah.
I hate to say it, but I forgot about my sister.
Contact Director Addison as soon as possible.
Right. Something about Andromeda viability and perks could be useful.
All right. Well, we still got a lot of stuff to do here. But you know what? Tomorrow's another day.